Vermentino is one of the most, I think, underlooked grapes that we have on our market. It's a grape, a white grape, that you'll find predominantly from Italy. And when I think of, when anyone thinks of Vermentino, Italy comes to mind first, especially from the island of Sardinia. The island of Sardinia produces, I mean, if you think of those pastoral rolling hills, you start to think of what this grape really is. And it's a grape often light in body, especially from Sardinia. It's a grape that's citrusy, herbaceous, fruity in terms of tropical fruits, and it has like a bitter, sort of a wonderful bitter finish that makes it interesting. Almost like lemon rind, even a nutty, like an, if you're biting into the, at the end of the almond on the skin, it kind of has that kind of finish, but they're tremendous wines. They're wines that go so well. They're really versatile. You can have as an aperitif. It's crisp, it's bright. They remind me, if you think of Sauvignon Blanc, but less powerful. If you think of Pinot Gris, but more complex and a little bit more interesting. So here you have a wine, I think, that would please so many people. Easy to say, Vermentino. And again, this one's from Sardinia. This is a bigger producer, so really widely available. You'll see it's Argiola's, even though they make, this is their entry level, they make some incredible, well-aged wines that have aging potential from Sardinia, but this is their entry one, and you'll probably see it often, but you just might not have been familiar with what it is. But if you like crisp white wine with citrus and peachy notes, you're gonna love this wine. It's also grown in other parts of Italy, especially in, if you've been to Cinque Terre, so all along the Liguria, you'll find it there, and Lunai is one that you'll find there as well. And it's also very much the same. I think it still has that light body, but it's grown on slopes that are so steep. It's almost like you can't even imagine how anyone walks up it. They have these chains, like it's that go around and around with these little baskets that come up and down the hill where they're, you know, hanging on for their lives, filling these baskets that are moving around mechanically. So super incredible, complex, fresh wines that if you're, you know, along the in the Mediterranean, you're gonna, especially if you think of this color, you're probably gonna have a glass if you're on the coast in Italy, especially the west coast. You'll also find it in Piedmont in the northwest part of Italy. It's also common there, especially in Bulgari and Tuscany. This is a Tuscan example, and it's a tremendous little wine as well. So you'll find it, Bulgari is really well known for their, you know, their super Tuscan reds, but they also make an incredible, a little bit richer style of Vermentino that's widely available. There's lots of different examples. Pagliatura is just one. Also, you'll find this grape smatterings throughout the country, United States, but another region that it's dominant in would be France, especially Corsica. That's kind of interesting because Corsica was at one time, pre-French Revolution, was an Italian country. So it makes sense that Vermentino is also a grape from there. So you find Faustine. Faustine has this great history. It's made by Abatucci Winery. One of the descendants still runs it. He was related to General Abatucci. And it goes back to the Napoleon Bonaparte days and the war and all this history and this amazing bottle. This is one of my favorite wines in the store. It's this complex, a little pricier, but this is a wine you can put away and age for 5 years. So this grape has tons of capacity. It's a little bit richer from the island of Corsica. Then you'll find it also throughout France, maybe in Languedoc-Roussillon, where it's also, I think, a little bit more expressive, a little bit more aromatic. And this is a tremendous example, and it does have a splash of Semillon on this one. But this is one of my favorite wines. I had grilled up some pineapple and put this just side by side. Incredible pairing, so unexpected. Again, tremendous food wines, great patio wines. I hope you give it a try. Go out and look for some Vermentino. Let's make that your summer wine this year.